What's going on, guys? It's Brother Andy from the Order of Science Fixontology, and right now I have a non-spoiler review of Spider-Man Homecoming. Alright, so no spoilers here. I'm just going to tell you why I think you should see the movie and if I thought it was good or not. Now, everybody who knows me knows I, as far as Marvel movies go, I've always been a huge fan of Captain America, Winter Soldier. That has been my basis that I related, you know what I'm saying, that I judged every Marvel movie on, that it had to be equal to or greater than that. This movie surpasses that, all right? I have to give shout-outs to Michael Keaton and Tom Holland. Excellent jobs. Michael Keaton is the best superhero villain since, or comic book villain since Heath Ledger played the Joker. Gotta give it to him. Zendaya, although her parts were far and in between, like she was in there, real dry humor, hilarious. She did well. Tom Holland killed it. Killed it as Peter Parker. And that's Spider-Man. This is the Spider-Man I remember as far as like I grew up. I remember reading about as far as how he's portrayed being a younger Peter Parker at 15, almost coming into his own, trying to earn respect. It's real good. It's okay paced movie. It dragged a little bit in spots, but those spots where it was dragging at, gave you a tons of information from beginning to end. The movie starts off well-paced, ends well-paced. It's just a little bit in the middle when it feels like they're trying to make you fall in love with some of the other characters, which they didn't have to try to force that on. But, dude, it's action-packed. It's a lot of nods to comic book stuff in there. There are multiple villains in the movie. You knew that from the trailers, though. Multiple named villains there, but I'm not going to tell you who that we actually know. But if you paid attention to the trailers, you should be able to see that there was a lot going on. Michael Keaton killed it. Killed it as Vulture. I mean, like, like, I've been waiting on something like that. We've always said that the problem with these movies is that the villains never live up to the hype. Like, they're always easily dispatched, and nah, this was the villain. Like, they did Vulture. Like, I don't ever remember Vulture being this dope in the comics. Like, they made him doper than he ever was in the comics. It was real cool. Like I said, Tom Holland hit it out the park. Just his wittiness, the try hard, you know what I'm saying, stuff. He just had it down. Still don't know how I feel about Hot Anime. Like, looking at Hot Anime, but still don't know how I feel about Hot Anime. Robbie Downey Jr. for the parts he was in the movie was good. It's a lot of people saying that they feel like this is an Iron Man movie. I don't understand how. I didn't feel like he was in the movie enough for it to be an Iron Man movie. So, I think just the Tony Stark that Robert Downey Jr. plays is so powerful and overtaking and has been the benchmark for characters in the Marvel Universe that, you know, when he comes on, he's a little, he can steer you away from what's going on because you're watching him to see what happens. But a lot of big action. It was pretty dope. I really, really liked it. Very well written. For you guys who go and see it, there is an end credit and there's an end scene, and then there's a post-credit scene. So both of them. Check both of those out. I don't really feel like they might move the plot along. I'm not sure. But it's cool. The dude that plays Happy gets a lot more screen time. And we had some other characters from prior movies return. So it was really, really cool. Like it was really like a high school comic book movie. It felt like Ferris Bueller's Day Out mixed with The Breakfast Club, but superheroes in it. So it gave me some of everything that I enjoyed when I was growing up as a kid. I would recommend go to see it. I saw it in a real 3D. I didn't go to IMAX, but to me, the movie would be even fantastic if you saw it in just straight digital. I splurged for that. Well, I didn't splurge for the IMAX. I got a Stubbs card, so I didn't have to, you know what I'm saying, pay full price for my ticket. So it was really dope. Take the chance to go see it, guys. I highly recommend this movie. Puts it above Winter Soldier for me. And y'all know for me that that's hard to put something like that above Winter Soldier. So when you see it, let me know what you guys think. You can leave comments at the bottom of this YouTube thing. And as always, for the order, again, check us out, scifitology.com. We got t-shirts and stuff for sale, with all types of pop and nerd swag and stuff on it. You can head over to the group on Facebook and see us talking about the movie, talking about different things. It's a huge argument about Dr. Manhattan and Thanos going on right now. And it's getting ready to be an argument on Green Arrow and Hawkeye that somebody started. So that's going to get real interesting. But like I said, scifitology.com, SYFYTOLOGY. Check us out. Come holler at us for the order.